Good afternoon, children. I hope you all enjoyed your summer vacation. Before vacation, you have seen videos related to two-digit numbers. In today's class, also, I am going to recap the same chapter, two-digit number. Today's date is 16-6-2020. 16 is today's date, 6 is month, 2020 is current year. Day is Tuesday. Two-digit numbers. Today we are going to see expressing numbers as tens and ones. Expressing numbers as tens and ones. Recognizing odd and even. Before, after and between. You would have seen before the vacation, again I am going to recap the same. First, I will recall tens and ones, expressing numbers as tens and ones. Taking a square box as an example, we will count how many tens, okay? One ones equal to one box. 10 ones equal to, see how many boxes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So we will represent these all 10 boxes in a strip. Hence 10 ones equal to 10 box. 10 ones equal to 10 box. When it is grouped, we get 1 10 box. See here. When it is grouped, we get 1 10 box. That is one strip of tens. This is called one strip of tens equal to 10. Here are some examples. See, one strip of tens equal to 10. Two strips of tens equal to 20. 1, 2, 3. Three strips of tens equal to 30. Same as 1, 2, 3, 4. Four strips of tens equal to 40. Here, five strips are there. Five strips of 10 equal to 50. Again, six strips of tens equal to 60. Same like that. See here, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Seven strips of 10s equal to 70. 7 strips of 10s equal to 70. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 strips of 10s equal to 80. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 strips of 10 equal to 90. Here you can see 12 ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10, 11, 12. So these all are 2 and 1s. When we group this 10s as one strip and 2 separately, it becomes 1 10s and 2 1s. That is 10 plus 2 equal to 12. Same. 3 10s and 5 1s. See here. 1, 2, 3. 3 strips of 10s. It is called as 3 10s. And again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 ones are here. It makes 5 ones. So 3 tens and 5 ones is what? 30 plus 5 equal to 35. Other example. 2 tens and 6 ones. See here. 1, 2. 2 10 strips are there. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 ones box are there. It is known as 2 tens and 6 ones is 20 plus 6 equal to 26. Children, take your textbook, listen carefully and do the sums with me. Grouping numbers. Exercise 1. Complete this using tens and ones to help. See here A. There are 10 beads put together and 3 separate beads. This 10 beads which are put together is represented as 110, and 3 separate beads are represented as 3 ones. So it becomes 10 plus 3. 10 plus 3 is equal to 13. In number names, we will write it as THIRTEEN, 13. The same way we will do the B sum. See here, 1 tens, one set of 10 pencils are grouped now. So it is called as 1 tens. How many separate pencils are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 ones are there. So we can write it as, with me only you can write, okay? We can write it as 10 plus 8, right? It is written in number names as 18. 1818. E-I-G-H-T-E-E-N, 18, right? Yeah. We will move on to C sum. See here, two sets of beads are there. 1, 2. These are called as 2 tens. And here, separate beads. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So 5 ones. So 2 tens make 20 and 5 ones make 5. So we can write as what? 25. 25, right? Then its number name is 25. We will write the number name here. TWENTY, 25. FIVE, 5. Okay. The same way they have written, see, 3 bundle of pencils are there. 1, 2, 3. It is called as 3 tens, right? Then again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 ones are here. 3 tens and 7 ones is equal to 30 plus 7, right? How we will write here now? We will write 30 plus 7 equal to 37. Okay. So in the same way, you have to do E to J sum. Okay. It will be your homework. Same way we can show in the abacus scale, tens and ones. We will see that now. You can also show tens and ones on an abacus. This is called as abacus scale. See here, tens stick and one stick. Here is an abacus scale. This is called as abacus scale. It has a stick of tens and a stick of ones. You can see here, stick of tens and stick of ones. Look at the picture. Tens. This is ones. In tens, how many beads are there? 1. In ones, how many beads are there? 1, 2, 3. See, one bead in the stick of tens, right? See here, one bead is in the stick of tens. 3 beads in the stick of ones. See here, 1, 2, 3. 3 beads are there in ones stick. 1 ten and 3 ones will be 1, 3, 13. 1 tens and 3 ones will become 13. Same way, see here, 10 strip is having 2 beads. 1 strip is having no beads. So 10 strip, we will write it as 2 beads. No beads are there in ones place. So 0 beads. So 2 tens and 0 ones make 20. Same way. See in 10 strip, how many are there? Stick 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 beads are there. So in tens place, 5 is there. And in ones place, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In ones place, 9 ones are there. So we will write as 5 tens and 9 ones. It is 59. We will do exercise 2 now. Okay, write with me. Take your pencil and you have to write with me only. Okay. Write the numbers shown in the abacus. See, tens, ones. How many are there in tens place? 2. So they have written as 2. In ones place, how many are there? Only 1. So they have written 1. So it is 21. The same way we will write here also. We will count the beats and we will write. Okay. See here, in tens place, how many are there? How many beats are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 beats are there. So we will write in tens place 5. In ones place, how many beats are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 beats are there. So we are writing as 57. Okay. Next. In tens place, how many beats are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 beats are there. So we are writing as 4. In ones place, how many beats are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 beats are there. So I am writing as 6. It makes 46. Same way, you have to do D, E and F sum as homework. Okay. Okay. Next, draw beats on the abacus to show the number. Now we will draw beats in the abacus scale to represent this numbers. Okay. First, I will draw now. Okay. How many beats are in tens place? 4. See here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Children, here I am not able to draw it properly, but I hope you all will draw very nicely. Okay. In 10, ones place, how many beats should come? Yes, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. You should draw it properly, okay? As here they have shown, you have to draw it properly, okay? So 47. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4. In tens place, 4, right? Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 beats I have drawn. So here, it is 7. In ones place, it is 7, right? The same way you do these sums as homework, okay? We will do exercise 3 now. How many tens are there in these numbers? See here, 1, 2. 2 tens are there. How many 9? 9 ones are there. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 beats are there. So they have written as 9. So how many tens? In tens place, which number is there? 2 is there. So they have written 2 tens. Same way here you see, 1 bundle is there. So 1 they have written, 1 tens. In ones place, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In ones place, 8 is there. In tens place, what is there? Number 1. So we have to write 1, 1 tens. Okay. 1, E, E, N, S, tens. The same way here, how many tens are there? 3 tens, right? Next, here see, how many tens are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here see, in tens place, what is the number? 5, yeah. We will write 5 tens. The same way here. What is the place value of 10 here? 8. So, 8 tens. I hope you all are writing with me. Please, children, do the classwork with me only, okay? Now see here. How many tens are there? 5. See here. In tens place, what is the number? 5. So we will write 5 tens. Okay. Next, here, how many are there? 9. 9 tens. It is very easy, no? Here, how many tens are there? 1 tens. Okay. Same way, this sum also. How many tens? 9 tens. 9 tens. Here, how many tens are there? See, in tens place, what is the number here? 7. 7 tens. Okay. Same way here also we will write. How many tens? 8 tens. 8 tens. Okay. Next. Here, see, 43. How many tens? 4 tens. In tens place, 4 is there. So, we write it as 4 tens. Here in tens place, what is the number? 2. So we write it as 2 tens. Now, write these numbers as tens and ones. See here, 43 is there. First, when two numbers are there, first number is in tens place and second number is in ones place. So we should write first number in tens place and second number in ones place. That is 4 tens and 3 ones. Same way we will write 25 also, okay? So we have to write 2 tens and 5 ones, right? Write with me, okay, children? Here, see. Now, 21 is there. How you will write? 2 tens and 1 once, right? Okay. Now again see. 36 is there. How we will write? 3 tens and 6 once, right? Okay. First number we have to write. When two numbers are there, first number we should write in tens place and second number as once, okay? See here, 68 is there. We will write it as 6 tens and 8 ones. Okay. Same way. Next sum. 42. 4 tens and 2 ones, right? Next sum. 7 tens and 0, no value. Then too we have to write 0 ones. Okay. Next. 92. 9 tens and 2 ones. Okay. Next sum. 39. 3 tens and 9 ones. Okay. Next. 88. 8 tens and 8 ones. Okay. I hope you all are writing with me. 52. How you will write 52? 5 tens and 2 ones. Next, last sum. 66. How you will write? 6 tens and 6 ones. Okay, children. Now you have understood, I hope so. Okay, next we will pass on to next exercise. Okay. Now I will teach you place value. Look at the numeral 9 on the abacus. 9, where is the 9? 9 beads, see here, it is in 1's place. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. The place value of 9 is, where is the 9? In 1's place. So we will represent this as 9 ones or 9. So 9 is in 1's place. So we represent it as 9 ones. See here. Now look at 35 on the abacus scale. We know that 35 is 3 tens and 5 ones. Previously we saw, we have seen that 3 is in tens place and 5 is in ones place. In the same way, we are going to represent in the abacus scale. See here, 3 tens in the tens strip and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 ones in the ones strip. Okay. The 3 in 35 means 3 tens. See, 3 in 35, it is in tens place. So we are writing as 3 tens. The 5 in 35, where is the 5 in ones place? So the 5 in 35 means 5 ones place. The place value of 3 in 35 is 3 tens or 30. We call it as 3 tens or 30. The place value of 3 is what here? 3 tens or 30. The place value of 5 in 35. Where is the 5 here? In 1's place. So we write it as 5 ones or 5. In the same way, we will do exercise 4. Write the place value of 4 in this abacus. 4 in this abacus. Where is the 4? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we will write the numbers and we will write here what is the place value. Okay. See here. Count the beads now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 is there in tens place. And again, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is there in ones place. What is the place value of ones here? 4 in this abacus. Where it is? 4 in ones place. So we can write it as 4 ones. 4 ones, right? Okay. Then 9 in this abacus. Where is the 9? We will count and write. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 in tens place. In ones place, what is the number we will see? We'll count the beads and we will see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Totally in ones place, 7 beads are there. They have asked 9 in the abacus. Where is the 9? 9 is in tens place. So we write it as 9 tens. Okay. Same way, 7 in this abacus. We will count first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What is in tens place now? 6. We will count ones place. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In ones place, what is there? 7. So, 6 is in. See, 7 in this abacus. Where is 7 here? In ones place. So, 7 ones. Correct? No? Okay. Write the place value of these digit in the number. Okay. See, first one. A in 59. 5 in 59. A sum 5 in 59. Where is the 5 in 59? In tens place. So we should write it as 5 tens. Okay. Now see. 8 in 18. Where is 8 in 18? 8 in 18 in ones place. So we should write as 8 ones. Correct? No. Then 2 in 24. Where is the 2 here? In tens place. So we should write 2 tens. Here see. 3 in 63. Where is 3 in 63? See here. 3 in 63. Where is the 3 in ones place? So we have to write 3 ones. Next, 1 in 13. Where is the 1 in tens place? So 1 is in tens place. So we write it as 1 tens. Again, 4 in 49. Where is the 4 in tens place again? 4 tens we should write. Okay. Then again, 9 in 89. Where is 9 in 89? In ones place. So it should be written as 9 ones. Okay. Next, 9 in 96. Where is 9? Here in tens place. So 9 tens. Here, 6 in 96. Where is the 6? 6 in ones place. So we should write it as 6 ones. Now we have seen the place value. How to write the place value? Now we will see odd and even numbers. Children are trying to stand in pairs. These cannot be put into pairs. See here. Here only one child. Can we put in pair? No one is there. So he can't be paired. Again, 1, 2, 3. 3 are there. 2 we are putting in pair. See here 1. Again for her no one is there. So we can't put in pair. Same way 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For 5 children also 2, 2, only 1. We can't be, they can't, it can't be paired. Same way for 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. For 7, 1, 2, 3. We can pair, but 1 will not have the pair. Again, same for 9. See here, they all are paired. Only 1 is left out. But these can be put into pairs. See, even numbers can be put into pairs. 1, 2, 2 are there. Again, for 4, see. Again, 2 pairs are there. Again, see for 6, 1, 2, 3. You can make it as 3 pairs. Again, see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Totally 8 members, we can pair it. Again, 10 members also, we can pair it. That's what. Numbers that cannot be put into pairs are called odd. See, which cannot be put into pairs are called odd numbers. That is 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. These numbers are called as odd numbers. Which all are called as odd numbers? 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9 are odd numbers. 13, 21, 45, 67, and 99 are also odd numbers. Why? We will tell. How? 13, 21, 45, 67, and 99 are also odd numbers. A number is odd if it has 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9 in its ones place. See here, in ones place, if any of these numbers, any of 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 is coming, means it is odd number. Okay. In ones place, whatever the number might be, 2-digit number, 3-digit number, whatever the number might be, in ones place, if 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 is coming, we called it as, we will call it as odd number. Okay. Same way, number that cannot be put into pairs are called, numbers that can be put into pairs are called even numbers. See, which cannot be put into pairs are called odd numbers. Which can be put into pairs are called even numbers. Okay. 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10 are even numbers. 12, 26, 44, 50, and 78 are also even numbers. A number is even if it has 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8 in its ones place. Whatever the number might be, 2-digit number, 3-digit number, whatever might be, in ones place, if 2, 4, 6, 8, 0 is there, means it is even number. Okay. We will do the exercise 5 related to odd and even numbers. See here. Ring the object in pairs. Write if the number or object is odd or even. We have to ring the numbers in pair and we have to write whether it is odd or even. Okay. See here. Now, 2 already they have paired. Again, now I am going to pair this both. Correct? No. Again, this also we can pair. So, we should write it as even. So here you can write it as even. This is even number. We can pair it, so we will write it as even number. Here second one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 numbers are there. Now we are going to pair this. If we pair, one, two. I can make 2 pairs, but 1 is left out here. So it will become what? Odd. Okay. So we have to write it is odd. Then again, same way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 are there. So you pair this and write whether it is even or even or odd. It will be your homework. Okay. Next, I'm going on to next one. Here are the numbers from 1 to 30. Ring the odd numbers in blue. Ring the even numbers in red. Now I will first ring even numbers in red color. Okay. See here. 2 is even number. 4 is even number. Again, 6 is even number. 8 will be even number. 10 will be even number. So I am ringing it in red color. Same way, you should also take red pencil and blue pencil and you have to do this. Okay. 14 is even number. Again, 16 is even number. 18 is even number. In ones place, if 2, 4, 6, 8, 0 is there, obviously it will become an even number. 20. Then again, 22. Then again, 24. Then again, 20. Sorry, children, 1 second. I'll do it again. Okay. 26. Again, 28. 30. So we have circled all the even numbers. You should do it properly in your book. Now I will take blue color to round the odd numbers. Okay. Already 1 is there as an odd. 1, 3 is odd. 5 is odd. 7 number is odd number. 9 is odd number. Again, 11 is odd number. 13 is odd number. 15 is odd number. 17 is odd number. 19 is odd number. 21 is odd number. 23 is odd number. 25 is odd number. 27 is odd number. 29 is odd number. You should circle it properly, okay? You children should circle it properly. See here, I have circled all the even numbers in red color and all the odd numbers in blue color. Now you have to do it as homework. Fill in the missing even numbers in order. You can do this as homework, okay, children? Now we will see before, after and between numbers. Okay. We will see before, after and between numbers. Look at the number strip. See here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. As you are in second standard, I hope you all know numbers 0 to 20 and you also know before and after numbers. It is very easy for you. See here, 3 comes after 2. See here, 3 is coming after 2. Again, 2 comes before 3. See, 2 comes before 3. Again, see here. 16 comes after 15. See, 16 comes after 15. It comes after 15. Again, 16 comes before 17. Before 17, what is there? Before 17, 16 is there. Like that. Before 16, what is there? 15. After 15, what is there? 16. Same way. 16 is between 15 and 17. See, 15 and 16 between, what is there? 16. So, we will do the exercise now. Exercise 6. Fill in the box. I will do two sums now. Remaining sums, you have to do it as homework. Okay. After 4, what will come? After 4, what is there? 5. Yes. After 4, 5. After 14, what will come? 14. After 14, 15. Yes. After 46, what will come? 46, 47. Right. Remaining sums, you have to do it as homework. Now we will do before numbers. Before 63. Before 63, what will come? 62. Right? Okay. Before 53, what will come? Before 53, what will come? 52. Right? Okay. Before 88, what will come? 87. Okay? I think you will do every sums because you are so thorough, I know. I have seen you in first standard. You are so brilliant students. You will do all this after before numbers. Now I'll do 3 examples of between numbers. After 25, what will come? 25. In between 25 and 27, what will come? 26. Yes. 25, 26, 27. Between 45 and 47, what will come? 46. Right? Between 30 and 32, what will come? 31. Okay. Now you will do all the sums as homework. I'll do fourth and fifth sum for you. Salma has read 60 pages of book. How many pages she has read? 60 pages of book. The page she has read to read. The page she has to read next is, see, 60th page she had read. The next page will be what? Salma has read 60 pages of a book. How many pages she had read? 60 pages of a book. The page she has to read next is. After 60, what will come? 61. Yes. She has to read. After 60, she has to read 61st page, right? Then, fifth sum. Harjit's father is 52 years old. How many years old he is? 52 years old. Last year he was dash years. Before. Last year means it is before. Before 52, what will come? Before 52, what will come? 51, right? I think, children, what all I have taught, you understood. Now you have to do the given homework. Okay, what all I have done with me only, I think you are doing. Remaining sums, you have to do it as homework after this video. Okay, after watching this video, you have to do it as a homework. I hope you all understood, children. We will see in the next class. Okay. Thank you. Have a great day.